Welcome to Winchester News Online with Stuart Appleby.
Hello and welcome to Winchester News Online. Here are today's top stories. Budget cuts, council jobs to go.
The worst case scenario we're looking at is about 150 job cuts.
Simulating success, Winchester's very own stock exchange. And cup triumph for Peter Simmons. Hundreds of council employees are facing the axe in an attempt by the council to make up an overwhelming debt. Joey Lipscomb reports.
Council employees are facing major job cuts following efficiency meetings revealing that they have overspent their budget. Labour politician Patrick Davies has slammed the council's actions.
I think they could be much more efficient, they could save money, and I don't think job losses would then be necessary. The county are now talking about large job losses, particularly in IT. But I don't think I've seen the final figures, and I'm not sure that the people involved have been told what's likely to happen. But I think it's symptomatic, really, of the very bad relationships between the city and the county councils, who could have cooperated over the years but have always abysmally failed to do so.
There's the worst case scenario we're looking at is about 150 job cuts.
With so many potential redundancies, what effect will this have on the local community?
It's going to affect the local economy, it's going to affect the government because people won't be paying taxes because they'll not be able to work. I would not like to personally to be in a position where I was made redundant and looking for work at this very difficult time.
With IT being the area most at risk, I came to speak to the head of the department here at Hampshire County Council. And although they refused to comment on video, they did release this statement.
Obviously it's a sensitive issue and people aren't really willing to talk as they're trying to keep their jobs.
I met with City Councillor Stephen Godfrey to discuss the council spending.
I think the residents of Winchester would expect a Conservative council to make the best use of their money. And we certainly hope to give value for money. It's theirs, it's not our money to spend. So if they think we're not looking after it properly by having a balanced budget, or by wasting on projects which people in the Winchester area don't support, then they'll soon let us know at the ballot box.
Joey Lipscomb, Winchester News Online.
A new opportunity will open for students at the Winchester Business School next year with the introduction of a working stock exchange simulator. John Hopley went along to find out more.
London Business School lecturer Bruce Webber has assured the University of Winchester's Business School that the introduction of a brand new stock exchange simulator will prove a huge success.
Today's been about learning to use TraderX, which is a software that's been developed by Bruce Webber at London Business School. The whole purpose of the day was to demonstrate the software to my staff so that next year they can start using it with the students. It's already a proven success. It's used at other business schools in the UK. Not many, because not many have got the facilities to do it. But about three or four business schools have got this software now. And where they've got it, it's been, the students love it. And they experience what it's like to be a market trader.
The idea was, let's put some live action into it. And each of the two simulations at the end, we saw who made money and who lost money. The important thing, though, is we learned about markets and we learned about how traders operate in those markets. You've got a great opportunity here. You're 1 hour on the train from the global financial center that is London. And I think if you go forward in your careers and understand trading and markets and what goes on in these large banks, some of the mystery of the city will go away.
John Hopley, Winchester News Online.
Students have been cleaning up Winchester with a voluntary litter-picking morning. The big tidy-up recruits volunteers from universities to tidy up local areas, but only 7 students from Winchester turned up for the day, and the event organiser thinks that more people need to volunteer.
People are asking, what's in it for me? Like, they need an incentive to come and help out. And it's a shame, because to be honest, the incentive is that you're getting experience, you're getting something that makes you more valuable. I think it's definitely something that people need to start doing more.
Winchester students are getting behind Fair Trade Week as the university supports it for a third year. Kaylee James has been following the event.
The university's Fair Trade Week has seen an improvement in student turnouts and support for its events. Fair Trade has been at the university for 3 years, growing stronger in support and awareness every year. It isn't just staff getting involved. Students are getting in the thick of the action too.
Each year we get more and more involved from students and staff. We had a fair trade lecture last Wednesday by David Payne, who's the head of the Africa Division for Christian Aid. Last 2 years we've had 30 and 50 people attend a lecture, and this year we had 81 people. So every year it's improving, and more students, which is obviously good.
But are the students really bothered or even aware of fair trade?
I don't normally, to be honest, look at what they are when I buy things, but if I had the choice, I would prefer to buy fair trade.
Not really. I buy the product, but I don't really care about it.
Would if it wasn't so expensive, but not really, no.
Yeah, I think the farmers should get what they owe from what they grew. So, yeah, I think fair trade is important and it should happen.
Kayleigh James, Winchester News Online.
And now it's over to Lucy Pilgrim with the sport.
Thank you, Stuart. A Winchester college was involved in the Hampshire Schools Under-18 Cup Final at the Winchester RFC, where they faced their Southampton rivals. Our sports team braved the weather to bring you this report.
It's a big day for rugby here at Winchester RFC, with three different cup finals taking place all on the same day, one after the other. Now, the one that we'll be covering, and the one that we're interested in, is a bit of a derby. It's between the Peter Simmons College and the King Edward VI School. Now, there's more spice added to this one, because the Peter Simmons coach is Mike Marchant, which is our very own Winchester RFC coach. So he'll be hoping to get a win on his home ground and take back the trophy for Peter Simmons College. Jason Curtis will be seeing this one with you.
The final attracted one of the largest crowds of the season, with rivalries on and off the pitch.
He's playing for King Edwards, and I'd like him to lose, to be honest, because I wasn't Simmons.
He seemed to be getting his wish as Peter Simmons created the move of the match, with Miles Roberts-Bailey breaking away to score after half an hour. After the conversion, they led 7-0 at half-time, with their players delighted. Tom Humberstone scored a penalty with just over 10 minutes to go, which seemed to end chance of a late comeback for King Edward. They didn't give up hope though and maintained some late pressure, but in the torrential rain they were unable to break through. The final whistle was greeted with delight by all associated with Peter Simmons, with the Winchester College running out 10-0 winners. The players decided to celebrate in a slippery style, but luckily for them, their rugby was far more clean. Captain Zach Kinnaird received the trophy for his team during the post-match ceremony. Both he and coach Mike Marchant had this to say after.
Yeah, definitely fantastic. I mean, Kez really came at us and we really held together as a team, so to win is fantastic considering the conditions as well. We've only lost once this season, and it was like in these conditions we lost 10-0, so to win 10-0 I think is quite significant.
It's great to be on a winning side. it's good. I mean, it's good for Hampshire Schools rugby, and it's really good for Winchester. You know, you look at the players that played, 44 players are involved today, probably 28-30 come from Winchester, so it's really good for the area as well.
And now is the non-league roundup. Eastleigh kept their chances of reaching the playoffs alive at the weekend with a 2-1 victory over fellow playoff rivals Staines Town. A 25-yard free kick from Sam Butler and an own goal from Yedo Mambo ensured the Spitfires took all 3 points. And AFC Totten further cemented second place in the Zamoretto League with a 3-0 victory over Yate Town last night. And that's it for the sports. Now back over to Stuart.
Thank you, Lucy. Now, you know where to find old books, but did you know you can also view old websites? Claire Rice Brandy went to find out how.
Tucked away in Winchester's record office, a team of dedicated archivists ferret away, banking old websites for us to view in generations to come. Hampshire is the only county in the UK to devote such attention to a potentially vital resource for the future.
A lot of people are involved in different parts of the process. We've got a collections management team of archivists. There's about four of them, and they're working with our collections manager to contact organisations and ask if they'd like to contribute their websites. We've also got an access and learning team, again, with about four archivists and a community archive development officer. And they're working with community archives to encourage them to nominate their sites as well. So different people are involved to a greater or lesser extent, about a dozen of us. Because it's a little bit of a lot of people's jobs. Those jobs would exist without the web archive, but to continue looking at different types of archives into the future.
If you have a website to donate, then please contact the Record Office. Claire Ice Brandy, Winchester News Online.
Thank you for watching. Join us again next week, and for the latest developments, log on to winol.co.uk. That is all from us here. Goodbye.